So a battery is a device that stores energy. The energy comes into the battery device in the form of electron. It will be released out of the battery and again in the form of electron. So electron in, electron out. The fundamental phenomena that enables this storage, the functionality of the device is electrochemistry. That's what makes a battery work. My name is Lei Cheng. I am a staff scientist at Argonne National Laboratory. So there are two types of batteries. One is a primary battery. Those are the typical AAA, AA batteries we buy from the store. You use it once, and those can be recycled and reused to make other batteries. And there is the secondary battery, which is also called rechargeable batteries. Examples of those are the batteries that you use in your laptops and cell phones. They can be charged and recharged. The rechargeability of that battery is very important. Think about if you have to replace a battery in your phone every time you use it. So I am very excited about the battery research I do at Argonne National Lab, and the specific applications we're aiming at are applications of batteries in electric vehicles and grid-scale energy storage. For example, electric vehicles can use electricity produced from renewable sources, such as wind and solar. I see a lot of solar panels installed in our neighborhood on top of the roofs. So these solar panel installations are typically coupled with the installation of a big pack of lithium-ion batteries. During the day when the sun is shining and the solar panel are harvesting energies from the sun, they get stored in those lithium-ion battery packs. And they can be later released to be used during peak demand hours, which is at night when everybody's home running the dishes and cooking and having the lights on. The wide adoption of these larger scale batteries will fundamentally change the way that we use energy.